it's time to dye my hair. Roots are showing, looking like Pookie. All I need is this.
Let's go.
Okay, so ever since I dropped the video for the ginger blonde hair tutorial, I've gotten a lot of questions as to how I did it. Crazy when you do a tutorial, step by step, showing people how to do something, they still have questions about how you did it. It's okay. I'm here to answer them. Because I understand. Maybe you weren't paying attention. Or maybe I didn't thoroughly explain it. Either way, I'm going to take that. Obviously, you can see I look like I'm getting ready to birth a baby. But I am not. I actually dyed my hair. And because I did the ginger blonde how to dye your hair tutorial, I wasn't going to give you another tutorial on how to dye your hair. I will answer your questions as my stuff is processing. Right now, I have 2 shopping bags on my head. Yes, that's 2 shopping bags. Dose plastic bags. Why? I feel no need to buy a plastic shower cap, let alone 2, when they give me a shower cap when I purchase the hair color. That's frugal for that. Now, instead of using the other hair color that I have in the video, and if you want to check out the ginger blonde hair tutorial video, you can look below where I will have a link, and I will also make it available so that you can click it somewhere by my face in this area. I'm no longer using that box. Now, I'm using the Soft Sheen Carson Luminous Blonde 396. Isn't she pretty? I like this color. Number one, it's a lot cheaper. The cost is a lot lower than the other color that I was using. I got this for $5.99, and the results are a little brighter, in my opinion, than the Soft Sheen, the other product. The Soft Sheen Carson Dark and Lovely box is a lot brighter than this, and this is Dark and Lovely. So, and it's also fade resistant. The conditioner in here, however, is not enough to condition your hair, and that's my firm opinion. It's not enough. You definitely gonna have to add your own conditioner. It comes with all your basic stuff, the instructions. I've been doing this so long, I don't even open it anymore. The High Lift Booster. This is the powder that you put into the bottle before you put your color in and you shake it up. So you want to use this High Lift Booster. This is the secret. Everyone wants to know, did you bleach your hair before you did this? No, it comes with the High Lift Booster. Why would I need to bleach my hair before I bleach my hair? Also, you have the Fade Resistant Rich Conditioning Hair Lightener. Like I said, $3.96 in this bottle here. And just in case you didn't see it before, the High Lift Booster comes in the bottle. And you put them all together. You shake it up real good. And you start working to them roots. You start getting to those roots, getting to the hair. Now, I want to give a special shout out to Anjela Jackson, who sent me an email asking me some questions about how I color my hair. And I want to answer them in addition to all the other questions that I received, because I want you guys to enjoy being ginger blonde, platinum blonde, 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 whatever. And I know you like it. I like it. And I really want to share with you how to do it. Mind you, it's 5:00 in the morning. Anjela asks, well, she said, I love the color results. She said, on your video, the GaptoothDiva's Ginger Blonde Hair Tutorial. Told you guys, I did a video already. She asks, When you dyed your hair blonde, did you have to bleach it first for it to lift to the right color? No, Angela. But thank you, though. Thank you so much for reaching out and asking that question. But no, did not have to bleach my hair before I bleached my hair. The results that you're seeing is after doing it for a while. I've been doing it for quite some time. Some suggest that you want to leave it in for 30 to 45 minutes. I have natural hair. So my time limit for this, and I know some professional hairstylists might be like, no. My process, I leave it in for an hour to an hour and a half. I surely do. But I always condition, and moisturize. First of all, having natural hair, you already know that you need moisture. Having natural hair, moisture is important. They tell you moisture. And I believe that. So I leave my hair color on a little longer because I'm just a rebel, just a dangerous rebel. Next question. How many times did you have to dye your hair in order to receive the platinum blonde results that you have? The very first time when I've gone either black or I've let my natural color grow out for quite some time, the very first time you dye your hair, it will not be platinum blonde. At least not right away. Unless you have very short hair. And when I did that tutorial, I did have very short hair. However, because the results don't come out as platinum blonde, you will need to do it a second time. And I would wait about 2 weeks to do that. So say 2 to 3 weeks for those of you who took 2 weeks and thought I said 1 week. Because I do that sometimes too. That's it. There's no secret science to it. It's not like a huge big deal. I really used the box color. And it only took me twice to get the results. And once I got the results that I have now, the color that I have now, I just kept dyeing my roots. And it always matched up with the rest of my hair. Angela was spitting them questions at me. Thank you. I like that. Angela asked, over what period of time between dyeing? Well, let me just say, prior to me growing my hair out and keeping it blonde, I always kept it short. So I would get my hair cut every 2 weeks. Therefore, I need to color my hair every 2 weeks. I didn't even have an inch of hair. Probably not even a half an inch of hair. Like, I was seriously bald. However, I dyed my hair every 2 weeks to make sure that it was bright, it was blonde, it was this. Now that I've grown my hair out and it's a little longer, a lot longer actually. I think I got like 4 inches of hair. Now, I have to dye my hair at least every 3 to 4 weeks. It really just depends on how I feel and where I have to go. Because you gotta have fresh roots when you go out. At least when you're taking pictures. I like my roots to show. People don't, you know, they compliment me all the time. I like that. I love your brown roots. I don't. But thank you. Did you have to tone it after dyeing it? I'll tell you a secret, Angela. No. I literally just use the box. The box has it all. The box holds all of the answers. Everything I used was in the box, except for the comb and the shopping bag and this blue thing that I stole from the hospital when I had a baby. Don't tell on me. That's pretty much it when it comes to dyeing your hair. I just wanted to share that there's really nothing to it. You do have to condition it when you're finished. It's very important that you get that done. And you do have to keep your hair moisturized. Also, I would also suggest to definitely keep your hair trimmed. I'm not good at that all the time. I'm going to be honest because I'm not going to make you think I'm perfect. Too much pressure. leave it on for slightly longer than what this box suggests, even though all the answers are in the box. Sometimes we don't listen to the box. Heat is very important. Hence why I have two shopping bags and this blue thing, because I need to make sure that it's hot up under here. And Lord, is it hot up under here. Get to that scalp. You use your tea tree oil. You use your avocado oil. You use the olive oil. Your Moroccan jojoba oil. All of that oil. And just put it all up in there. And stop being scared of having moisturized hair. Should nobody be touching it anyway. And that's pretty much it. So check out my ginger blonde hair tutorial. And check this out, because I'm answering your questions. And then in the meantime, in between time, I'll check you guys out later. Thank you so much for listening. Have a good one.